वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स इन खुशिंदर सर क्लासेस. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन फॉर द चैप्टर द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ अ लेडी रिटन बाय खुशवंत सिंह. सो लेट अस प्रोसीड विद अवर चैप्टर. बट बिफोर वी विल प्रोसीड, आई विल टेल यू दैट इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू लर्न द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, यू कैन सी माई अर्लियर वीडियोज दैट आई हैव अपलोडेड ऑन यूट्यूब. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद अवर MCQs. First MCQ is, what type of lady was the author's grandmother? First, cruel lady. B, religious lady. C, violent lady. Or selfish lady. Here, religious lady is the correct answer. Our next MCQ is, the chapter, the portrait of a lady, is about the writer's grandfather, mother, grandmother, grandmother and grandfather both. Here, our answer is grandmother, as this chapter is all about Khushwant Singh's grandmother. Next MCQ is, what breakfast was given to the writer? Writer को खाने में क्या दिया जाता था breakfast के तौर पर? तो फिर यहाँ पर हमारे option है bread and butter, curry and rice, milk and eggs, thick stale chapati with butter and sugar. तो फिर यहाँ पर हमारा answer हो जाएगा thick stale chapati and butter and sugar. Our next question is, what does the writer say about his grandmother looks? Had gracious looks, very beautiful, old and wrinkled, or none? Here our correct answer is old and wrinkled. Fifth MCQ is, the grandmother's one hand was on her waist. What was in her hand? A book, a rosary, a pen, or a spinning wheel? Here our answer is a rosary. That is the correct answer for this MCQ. What did the grandmother do when she bathed and dressed the writer? Here the options are, she sang film song, she taught him to song, she taught him alphabet, or she said her morning prayer. So here our correct answer is, she said her morning prayer. After it, our next MCQ is, what idea did the author form of his grandmother or grandfather? She had ever been old. His grandmother had a large number of grandchildren, both A and B, or neither A nor B. So here our correct answer is C, both A and B. That is, she had ever been very old. His grandmother or grandfather had a large number of grandchildren. So our next multiple choice question is, what did people say about the author's grandmother? She was once young and pretty, she was old and wrinkled, she was a religious woman, or none of the above. So here our correct answer is, she was once young and pretty. So let us go to our next MCQ. What did the grandmother say about her childhood days? A. She told stories of her naughtiness. She told of games she used to play as a child. She told about her childhood friends. Or all of the above. So here our correct answer is, she told of games she used to play as a child. Our next MCQ is, in the beginning of the story, the writer and his grandmother lived in a hotel, a gurudwara, a village, or a city. So here our correct answer is a city. Our next MCQ is, the writer grandmother carried several stale chapatis with her for the writer, the priest, dogs, monkeys. So here our correct answer is C, dogs. After it, our next MCQ is, where was the writer's school? लेखक का घर कहाँ पर था? नियर टेम्पल, नियर सिनेमा हॉल, नियर कॉलेज, और नियर बैंक. सो हेयर आवर करेक्ट आंसर इज ए, नियर टेम्पल, मंदिर के पास. नेक्स्ट MCQ, हाउ कैन यू से दैट द ग्रैंड मदर वॉज रिलीजियस? ए, ऑलवेज टेलिंग द बीड्स ऑफ हर रोजरी. बी, हर लिप्स कॉन्स्टेंटली मूव्ड इन ऑडिबियल prayer. C, both A and B, or neither A nor B. So here our correct answer is C, that is both A and B, always telling the beads of her rosary and her lips constantly moved in inaudible prayer. Next MCQ is, when the writer was at school, what did his grandmother do? A, she sat in the temple reading scriptures, served in temples, fed the priest or fed the dogs. So here our correct answer is A, that is she sat in the temple reading scriptures. Next MCQ is 15th. How did grandmother spend her time? दादी माँ अपना समय कैसे व्यतीत करती थी? At the spinning wheel, by talking to priest, by serving at Gurudwara or all. So here our correct answer is at the spinning wheel. वो गांधी जी की तरह चरखा काता करती थी. Next MCQ is what was the turning point in the relationship between the writer and grandmother? दोनों के बीच में ऐसा कौन सा टर्निंग पॉइंट था grandmother और राइटर के अंदर? A. When the writer was given a separate room, when they went to the city, when she died, or when the writer went to England. So here our correct answer is B, that is when they went to a city. Our next MCQ is what made the grandmother unhappy? Dadi maa ko nirashajanak kya banata tha? A. She could not say her prayer. B. She fell ill. C. She could not help with the writer in his study. Or D. All. So here our correct answer is C, that is she could not help the writer in his studies. 18th. How did the grandmother feel to know about the music lessons? A. Music was associated with harlots and beggars. B. She felt very happy. C. She wanted to sing. Or D. None. So here our correct answer is A, that is music was associated with harlots and beggars. Our next question is what did the grandmother feed in the city house? Here the options are dogs, pigeons, priests or sparrows. So here our correct answer is D, that is sparrows. Our next MCQ is what was the happiest half hour of the day for her? दादी माँ के लिए सबसे खुशी वाला आधा घंटा कौन सा हुआ दिन का? A. When she fed the sparrows. B. When she fed the dogs. When she recited prayers. Or when she went to temple. So here our correct answer is A, that is when she fed the sparrows. Our next MCQ is who decided to go to abroad? किसने बाहर जाने विदेश जाने का निर्णय लिया? तो फिर यहाँ पर हमारा ऑप्शन दिए हुए हैं ग्रैंड मदर, ग्रैंड फादर, ऑथर्स मदर और द ऑथर. सो हेयर आवर करेक्ट आंसर इज डी, द ऑथर. और नेक्स्ट एमसीक्यू इज व्हाई डिड द ऑथर डिसाइड टू गो एब्रॉड? ए. फॉर स्पेंडिंग हॉलीडेज. बी. फॉर स्टडी. सी. फॉर ट्रीटमेंट. डी. फॉर पिकनिक. सो हेयर आवर करेक्ट आंसर इज बी, दैट इज फॉर स्टडी. 23rd MCQ, how long did the author stay abroad? A. Forever. B. For 5 years, for a month or for 10 years. Here our correct answer is B, that is for 5 years. So let us proceed with our next MCQs. What change did the author notice over the grandmother after returning from abroad? A. She talked about her illness. B. She beat on old drum. C. She stopped saying prayers. Or she started spinning. So here our correct answer is A, that is she talked about her illness. After it, our next MCQ is what were the children taught at the village school? Our first answer is alphabet. B. Prayer. C. Both A and B or none. So here our correct answer is C, that is both A and B, alphabet and prayer. 26. How did the author grandmother react to his receiving education in an English school? A. She was unhappy. B. She was very happy. C. She did not bother. D. None. Here our correct answer is A, that is she was unhappy. Wo bahut dukhi thi. 27. How did the grandmother relax in the afternoon? Our first option is A, she would sleep for some time. B, she would feed the sparrows. She, both A and B or neither A nor B. So here our correct answer is she would feed the sparrows, that is B option. After it, our MCQ is 28. Why did the grandmother not accompany the author to his school in the city? First option is, the author now went to school on his bicycle. B, the author now went to the school by rickshaw. The author now went to school in a motor bus, or none. So here our correct answer is C, that is the author now went to school in a motor bus. Next MCQ is, how did grandmother celebrate author's homecoming? A, she gave a grand treat to neighbors. B, she took an old drum and sang for many hours. C, both A and B. Or D, none. So here our correct answer is B, that is, she took an old drum and sang for many hours. After it, our next MCQ is, and the last MCQ is 30th. How can you say that the sparrow had not come from the bread? A, the sparrow didn't touch the breadcrumbs. B, they flew away as soon as the dead body was carried off. C, both A and B. Or D, none. So here our correct answer is C, that is both A and B. The sparrows didn't touch the breadcrumbs. B, they flew away as soon as the dead body was carried off. Students, if you have understood it very well, kindly like and subscribe my channel to get latest update and notification of education. So let us end our video. Thank you and have a nice day, students.